The functions and the features, I've divided them in these three areas. You can stop me anytime you want to go deeper in something. If you want to know more about the themes, or the layouts, or the extending of classes or features, just ask and we can go deeper into it. As far as I can see, just check if we have internet access so we can switch to live sites, for example, to see how things are working or how things are done. But yes, just ask during the talk, because I think it will be a bit late when we answer the questions at the end. So I think it's better to do it during the talk. Okay, it's time, and I think we can start. Customizing VirtualMart is not an easy task. It's quite difficult because VirtualMart itself is a very complex system, which is in the nature of an e-commerce system, but VirtualMart as a grown system over years, extended, it makes it a bit more difficult to find the places where and how to extend or to customize it. But there are ways and tools that could help. Oops, wrong direction. Could help you finding the correct places. And there are some basic tips how to get started with customizing VirtualMart. The first and most important is get Firebug. Use Firefox and use Firebug. It will help you a lot to find the places where to change something in VirtualMart. In combination with that, take a copy of the VirtualMart package and extract it on your local hard drive and use full text search for the things you find in Firebug. You can search for them in the full text search, and also copy a copy of your language file, and then you need two steps. You may find the language string in the language file, and then there is the variable name for this language string, and then you can search in the code for this variable name. The third one is use the VirtualMart debug feature. A lot of people don't know that in the configuration of VirtualMart, you can switch on the debug feature of VirtualMart. And when you load the page, there are a lot of icons on the page. When you move the mouse over the icon, you can see which template or which template file in the theme has rendered this specific part of VirtualMart. This helps a lot to find the files to edit. And as always, don't hack the core code. In 95% of all things you may need, it is possible to find a solution without hacking the core code. As I said, three different parts. The layout, which is the VirtualMart themes, its templates. Functionality, which is mostly in the VirtualMart user classes, and features. These go together often, but I divided them in functionality and features because features are most often extra things you add to your VirtualMart, and there are different ways to do that. When we start with the layout and how the VirtualMart themes are working or how they are planned, how it should work. The location of the themes, you might know. If it's all too basic, just tell me, then we can skip this. The location of the VirtualMart files is in the front end, in the component directory of the front end, Joomla front end components, in components.com VirtualMart themes. And there you find this structure. There is a default template, default theme from VirtualMart with this structure. There are more subdirectories, but this is the basic structure. And as you can see, the directories are named like the areas where the themes or the templates are used. Yeah, you can also find the CSS file and JavaScript and so on, but we'll see this later. When you start your own theme, just make a copy of the default theme. Then you can always go back to the default theme. I see a lot of shops where they just start working in the default theme, but the biggest problem is when you install one of the frequent updates of VirtualMart, the default theme directory will be overwritten or may be overwritten with files in the update. Yes, as I said, the directory structure tries to represent the areas where the templates are used. And you can use the debug mode in VirtualMart to identify the files. This is the structure you will see then in the front end when you use the debug mode. Another feature from VirtualMart is that you don't need all the files of the default template. VirtualMart checks if there is a custom file. If not, it switches back to the default theme. So you can have your custom template or your custom theme directory with only the files you have changed. That's nicer because there are a lot of files in the themes directory, and it's easier to find the files you have changed then. You might know that to change the active theme, you have to go to the VirtualMart configuration page, and on the third tab side, you find a drop down where all the theme directories you have are listed in the drop down, and you can select this. And when you save the configuration, you have changed the active theme. Under this drop down, this is not you cannot see it now. There is a link where you can go to the configuration page of the theme. Yes, directly in the themes, as you have seen, there are different subdirectories. One of them is the product details, where the fly pages, the product detail pages, are stored. And depending on what you have configured in your products, or in the categories, the fly page file name is loaded. So this is the default flypage.tpl.php, which comes with the default template. And there are different blocks of code. I try to separate them. It's a bit difficult, otherwise it would be too small. This is the basic line you will find in nearly all Joomla files of every extension. Here it's commented the buttons header. This is the link to the previous and next page, and here the default table with the product description and the images start. Most of the variable names are self-explaining, but sometimes you run it is something else that you expect, because there is a data or if you think it's just the name of the product image, sometimes it is the full path, the full URL. That can sometimes be annoying, or you have to check what really is stored in the variable. But VirtualMart tries to help you to deliver directly the URL, so you can have just one variable name for the product image. This is something different. This is a call to a function in the VirtualMod classes, where VirtualMod looks up if there are additional images. So you can see there are different ways to put information in the template using the variable names, the function calls, and configuration variables, and of course the default HTML of the side of the page. Yes, there are some things in there you shouldn't really know, should not or may not use on your side, like this table structure and so on. But it's your decision how to change this, and yes, and this is the rest of the. Oh, ich gehe in die falsche Richtung. Sorry, wrong direction. Yes, that's the rest of the product description table. Here you can see that there are related products, product review form. There is a whole block of code in this simple variable. If you don't want the product review form because you don't offer your product reviews in your shop, just delete these two table rows and they're gone. Exactly the same with related products and so on. Vendors, okay, there is also an if clause for the configuration. And yes, that's the rest. This is now an example of a different Flypage theme, where we have added some custom code, some other features. First, we've made a div structure here. We didn't use the table structure of the default template file. We made a div structure and have made a completely different layout. Here are some hard-coded strings. This is not what you should do, but I just left it in there to show if it's your shop and you know this is the link you want to show and there is nothing variable and no languages and so on, then you can of course do it. It's easier, it's faster to just write it in the theme file, in the template file. What do we have here? Yes, there is an additional feature in what we added to the Flypage theme, and this is an advantage of VirtualMod. You can use all PHP code. You can use can write your own scripts within the theme files to add functionality or to add features, to add fields to the products and so on. And this is an example where a shop offers a bonus card system, and for several products he has different bonus percentage which will be calculated for the products. And here we've added a function, this BC show bonus, where it checks if there is a bonus for this product, and if there is a bonus, it shows a bonus image and so on, and displays all the stuff. And this is the page which is rendered here. This is exactly the page that is created here, and this is the bonus button. And on other pages, when there's a product without bonus, then this button is not shown. Okay. No. Yes. What else is in the themes? What belongs to the layout area? In the themes directory, there is also the images directory, where you find all the images that are used by VirtualMod. The most famous is the blue add to cart button. which is in there, but also all the other images that you can see on the page. Then the theme CSS, this is the whole layout information for the custom theme. Sometimes it's needed to put things in the Joomla template CSS when you have modules that do not load the theme CSS. That may sometimes tricky. Also for the cart module, there's sometimes you can see this if you have commercial Virtumat templates or from template clubs. I know some Joomla art templates, for example, where a lot of stuff is in the Virtumat CSS, as CSS is in the template directory. The theme.js is the JavaScript file which is loaded with the theme. Most of you will know the add to cart box which pops up when the add to cart button is clicked, and this is loaded in this file. So you can add different behaviors in the JavaScript for your theme directly. And another file in the themes directory is the theme.xml. This is nearly the same structure as you might know from Joomla components or extensions, where you have parameters to configure the theme. In the default theme, there's also a theme XML where you have these, I don't know if you can read, maybe you have seen it in your administration, where you have the different options you can configure in your theme. This is often very helpful if you want to build a shop which somebody else uses, and you can put strings and all kind of information in here what the user can edit in his configuration then. Okay. Yes. Do you want to go deeper into the layout section, or should we go further to the features and user classes and so on? I don't know what your preference is. Okay. Yes. How to add custom features in Virtumat? There are different ways to do this. Of course, often you can use add or add additional components and add-ons. There are a lot of add-ons available for free and for commercial. JAdd, the Joomla extension directory, has its own extension-specific category for Virtumat, where you can find, I think, about 150 extensions, and also on virtumat.net is an extension directory. But you can also create your own. This is always a decision what the best way is to solve a problem. We often create a plugin or a component to create a solution for something a customer or somebody wants, because we then have the full control over the code we are doing, and we don't have to change the core code from Virtumat or whatever. And this is for several things, this is the best solution. But if you want to add features to the themes, like as we've seen the bonus feature, you can use the themes.php in the themes directory, and there is a line your code here please in the file where you can add your own code to extend the PHP in this file and to add features in the theme. And as we saw, it was with the bonus feature, it's called then this arrow and your function name. And the third one is the user classes, where you can extend Virtumat. When you when you load or when you decide to create an add-on for VirtualMod or a component or whatever, it's always a good idea to load the VirtualMod mainframe. It's the VirtualMod loader. When you check one of the modules that come with VirtualMod, then you can see or can also see that this VirtualMod parser file is always loaded. The advantage is the whole VirtualMod configuration and language files and so on are loaded with the parser, with the VirtualMod parser PHP, and you can use the defined the constants like path names and settings and all the things the user can change in the VirtualMod configuration. And yes, it's much better if you do this than define the variables on your own. Yes, next one is use the VirtualMod constants when you load an image, for example. There is a defined constant in VirtualMod which is image path and image URL. Which path is the full path on the server, and the URL is of course the path to the link for the browser. So you don't have to care for all this stuff on your own, and it's better to use this than to hard code components, ConvertMod, shop images, and products, and then to use these constants. And when you are creating add-ons, modules, or whatever, always try to think about if there is a theme you could use from VirtualMod. The best example is the product snapshot theme, which loads a small box with a product display, product image, and you can select if you want to show the add to cart button or so. The big advantage is you don't have to care for all this stuff. You create a module where you select product IDs from the database with parameters you want to show. And you have a list of product IDs, and then you can say, show me these three products, and just shoot the product ID or product SKU. I don't know why, but the product snapshot is called with the product SKU and not the product ID. Is there any reason for that? I always wanted to ask that.
There's a reason for that, but I'm not sure at the moment.
Okay. The product snapshot function is called with the product SKU, or the instead of the product ID, but then you don't have to care for all the fields that are loaded, for the prices that are loaded, all the settings in VirtualMod, the shopper group prices and so on are triggered without you having to care for this. And that's something I always try to use as much VirtualMod standard functions as possible. Most of the additional features that VirtualMod may not offer are just a selection of products or just to display them different, but often you can use the default elements of VirtualMod. And this is something when you write an add-on, you can check or you have to know a bit about the features or the functions that VirtualMod offers. Like this product snapshot, you must know that it's there, that you can call PS product class with the show product snapshot function. And then the product snapshot will be loaded. Yes, as I said, when you use the theme.php, you can find it in the theme root. Then you can create new functions in this file. It's just as an example, you can add a function like in here, display product ranking. You can add a query to the function where you select like top seller ranking, which ranking this product is, for example. This is the function you add to the theme.php, and in the template or in the fly page template, for example, you can add this line, echo this display product ranking product ID, and then you will output the result of this function. That's very easy because you always have all the functions of the theme.php available in the current object of the theme, and can just refer to it. And as we saw earlier, you can define configuration parameters in the theme.xml, and you can use these parameters or the variables in the theme with this command. Again, the current object and get configuration and the name of the variable you've defined in the XML file. This can, of course, be used for if clauses. For example, if you configure something like show related products, then you have a yes or no in the variable, and then you say if get configuration show related products equals no, then skip this block with the related products, for example. Yes, the user classes are a bit of both. You can add features, but it's more the functionality of VirtualMart, because you work directly in the code of VirtualMart. I don't know if you have seen the backend structure. If you have seen the backend structure of the directories in VirtualMart, you can the com VirtualMart directory, and below that there are classes, HTML, and so on. And the classes directory is full of files that mostly start with ps underscore and is a name, like ps products, ps product categories, and so on. These are the classes VirtualMart uses. It's not clean object-oriented programming in VirtualMart, but these are classes that can be extended or can be overwritten. The problem in VirtualMart was that nobody expected it when these classes were created, that there will be a need to extend these classes in several ways, and in the meantime, add-ons were released, and they loaded the pre-PS product class, for example. So it was difficult to change something without breaking the functionality of add-ons, for example, because they rely on the functions that are in the PS product. So we have added something that is working very good, but it's not the clean theory of object-oriented programming, but it works very good for and it works with third-party add-ons that don't even know that you're changing something, and the user classes are a way to extend or override the VirtualMart classes. You can add functionality and you can change the basic functionality. If you have or if you are in VirtualMart and you have a point in the code where you say, oh, if it could do something here, it would help me very much, but I don't want to hack the core code, you can just use this function, add your own code there, and from this point on, VirtualMart does this function the way you have written it. The feature is added in VirtualMart 1.1.4, and it's available for nearly all classes in the classes directory. And there's just one other file. It's the shop browse queries.php. The php is here in the HTML directory. I'm often asked why we don't add this feature for the files in the HTML directory. That's a bit difficult because the files in the HTML directory are not in a class structure. They are just code that is executed from A to Z, and there can be includes and returns and whatever in there. What we don't know, and that would be very difficult, or sometimes auch very. It could be for security reasons not very good to allow this feature in the HTML directories. But the shop browse queries is not a page file or so. It's just the file where the query for the browse pages is created or generated. And if you have worked with different Virtumart shops, this is one of the points where you often have to change something, because this is the point where Virtumart sometimes gets slowly and so on, because this query, which is created in the shop browse queries, has to cover all of the features and all of the parameters and all of the limitations you can add for the product display. It checks if there are several prices for products, the shopper groups, the taxes, and so on. And if you have a lot of products, it sometimes is useful to optimize this file. And that's why we have added this for the user classes feature too, even though it's not a class file itself. Yeah, how do we use this? In the themes directory, there's a directory user class, and just create a new file in there and name it like the class you want to extend. Like in our example, psproduct.php, create a new file, psproduct.php, in the user classes directory. And then you can add code to this. Okay, just a second. You can add code or functions to this file. And just one tip: sometimes it is possible to use to execute the code of the original class. For example, if you just want a function to do something else before the rest of the code is executed, then write your own code and then just give the control back to the original function, so you don't have to check the whole function in your custom class. Then this is more secure, and even when there are updates and the class is updated, you automatically have the execute the updated code. I don't know if you can see that, but this is an example of the PS product user class, where we have rewritten the product snapshot function. You can add an original function of the class you want to extend, and name it exactly the same, or just copy and paste the original code and do whatever you want in the code then. And this function, when this function is called product snapshot in the PS product, it will then execute your custom code and not the original function in PS product. Yeah, there are two lines, as always, the security feature, and then you have to define the class. You have to define the class PS product, which extends the VM PS product. That's important that Virtumart knows that you are extending the original file. Yes, and then you can do whatever you want. And but you must be aware, this, of course, if you create an error in here or something that leads to a security hole or whatever, this is not Virtumart code, it's your code. You have to test it very, very much, and you have to be sure that this is okay what you're doing, because this is really deep within VirtualMart. You have a lot of things you can do with this, but always be aware you are picking something directly out of the heart of VirtualMart and do your own code and let VirtualMart handle the stuff afterwards then. And but it offers a very, very big or very much flexibility to have influence on how VirtualMart works. yes, and you can also, of course, create new functions. They can be called directly in the VirtualMart code, like the original functions. If you have a unique function, which is called product snapshot big, for example, then you can call it in your theme or other code with the default $P as product arrow product snapshot big. That's it becomes part of the VirtualMart classes then. Okay, that's the rest of the file then, and you can see you don't need to copy the whole class file. It's in you just can use the functions you want to override or to extend. For security reasons, the user classes have to be activated in the VirtualMart configuration, because everybody who has access FTP access to your server could add a file there and the code would be executed then. So you have to activate this feature in the configuration file or in the VirtualMart configuration. Otherwise, these files will not be loaded.
Do you have the line of the usage of parent class in your code example?
Yes, we can go. I hope that we have. Yes, we are online now. I want to go into existing examples to show how things could work. This is all theory now, and with the questions, I can show you real examples, and we can see how things are done or could be done. It's like always, this is not the only way how to find a solution. There are always different ways, and depending on your shop, on the number of products, and on a lot of parameters, it's sometimes difficult to decide how to create a solution. Yes, I can. Let me mal gucken, that I can put the browser on this. There it is. Okay. Control. So where do we want to start? Maybe you could start with the example of the page where we had the bonus product. This is when you look in this direction and try to okay. Also the, it's possible. We have also an example on this page to have category landing pages, for example, in VirtualMart. I think it's not very nice in the default VirtualMart that you have only the category list, and if there's only one category, you have just one image there. And if it's sometimes nicer to have a list of featured products also in the category overview, and this can also be done in the themes. So this is what we saw in the code. Where is the mouse now? And for those of you, I don't know if anybody of you already uses development environment. It helps a lot if you have a grown-up editor that helps you with the Joomla framework and the VirtualMart classes, because when you, for example, with this editor, when I now start to write something, all the functions that are in PS product, for example. So now I refer to the class PS product, and now the editor shows me all the functions that are available in PS product. That helps a lot finding the way through VirtualMart and Joomla also, because it's much easier to, if you don't have to search for this or open another file all the time. And when you just select a function, then there's a little helper, a pop-up where it shows what parameters are expected and so on. That could help a lot then. And now we go to the page. Components. When you're used to a much larger monitor than this is ConvertioMart, you can see, for example, here's an example where we have added another component to do VirtualMart things, because it was much more flexible to put this in an extra component and then to use it in VirtualMart. So this is the custom theme of the shop we've just seen, and are we offline? And this is the directory structure below the theme. We have added some or one more directory, but these are the default directories. I don't know why we doesn't load the. Problem with the internet connection here. Failed to connect. Try if it. Cannot connect to our test server too. Okay, I'll do it with the. Do the classes. So this is, for example, a user class where we have extended the as an example for change the function of the PS product class add, where product is added to the database. It's just a simple email function that an administrator would be contacted that a new product is added to the database, and this for example is in the first line there you can see vm underscore ps product add, that this is the original code that is executed. So we execute the original function, and after the function, when the function is completed, because if you look at the original function, it returns if there's any error in adding the product, it returns without a product ID. So if there is a new product ID, we know that there is a new product, and we just send out an email. So we don't change the whole bunch of code that is used to store a new product, because I really wouldn't do that, because that's very, very basic functionality of VirtualMart, and we just wanted to inform somebody that something has happened, and so we have extended this function, and that's, yeah, when you look at it, it's very easy. The only thing is you have to know that it is possible, and what to use to make it possible. if you would have hacked the core, you would have placed this block of code directly in your PS product file, and this is something we could prevent with this user class structure. This is much more secure, much more updated. If you have updates, it will not be overwritten, and even if in an update the original class returns something you didn't expect, so that you have to rework this file, it's very easy. Just rename the file on the FTP server, and it is not executed anymore. So you can work on it, add corrections and so on, and just rename it back, and then it's back in work. It's easier to do it this way than to scan all the code and search for changes you have made in the original code, because we all know after 2 or 3 weeks you don't know all the places where you've changed something, and okay, if you've done it right, then you have added comments, of course, but it's always difficult to work in the original files. And this is a very clean and very, very secure way to add features to very basic VirtualMart functions. Weitere Fragen dazu? Ich weiß es nicht, wie gesagt, ich würde gerne Live-Sachen zeigen dazu, aber... Another nice thing you can do here is in the PS checkout class, which is the file that handles all the checkout functions and sending the user email and so on after when the order is stored. You can also use the PS checkout, for example, to create an invoice PDF or so, or send other information to other users. At the moment, there is only one copy of the order user email is sent to the shop admin. If you want to send other information to different salespersons or so, then this is a good place. And also, Yes, there is also a file which is responsible for the order changes, and this is also called on the notify of, for example, PayPal. When the PayPal IPN confirms the payment, this order status change is called, and you can also add functionality there if you want to add features when the payment is confirmed, like adding a user in a special database. We often do this for Docman, for example, when we sell downloadable products where we need more features than the built-in download feature from VirtualMart. We often use Docman, for example, because it has group, you can add groups and so on. And then when a customer is paid, his user record is added to a Docman group, and he has access to downloads. This is a very very simple example with about 10 lines of code. It's just one database query to add the user to the Docman file, Docman database, and when and you have a whole download system behind your VirtualMart then. There are a lot of scenarios where you can use this, but okay, you have to work a bit with the original code, because you have to know what functions you will need to extend. Sometimes even for people who know the code or nearly every line of code, sometimes it's not possible to extend or find a solution without changing the VirtualMart core code. There's only just one tip, one tip. As often as possible, use includes. Don't write the code into the original file. Just write another new file and put the code in there and include it and at the position where you want to execute the code. The code will be executed exactly the same way as when you put it in there, but it's much better to handle after weeks or months when you have if there's an error or an update or whatever, because you have your include directory and see with one view which things you have changed, because for me it is so, I always forget something when I've changed the original code, and then there is a problem and so on. So if you want to do this, just use includes. A more professional approach to this, which we do since I think half a year, is that we use Joomla plugins for this. It's very easy to make a component use Joomla plugins. You have to just to call a so-called Joomla dispatcher, which loads the VirtualMart plugins then, and then you just trigger the functions in the plugins. I don't know if you have ever programmed or checked the plugins that come with Joomla. It's always a function, and it's called on after save content, for example. And this on after save content is the place in the flow of Joomla where this plugin is triggered. And when you now have to add the core, hack the core code of VirtualMart, then consider adding just a plugin trigger there. When you say, for example, on change order status, for example, then you can add a plugin which does, for example, the code that adds the user to Docman. This is a bit more professional, because you can disable this plugin in the Joomla configuration when something happens. You don't have to go to the FTP. It's much easier for the user if you develop a shop for somebody else to see what's going on. And you can even add parameters to the plugins, for example. And and in this regard, you all might know the Joomla modules. It's also very easy to add the module positions directly to VirtualMart. I hope I can show you. Robert promised me that I am online here now, but because most of the code is on our demo servers and test servers, you can add modules to VirtualMart directly. It's just two lines of code of Joomla framework code you have to add to VirtualMart, and you can define your own module positions. This can be done in the themes.php. I will show you the code. I have it somewhere here. Then you can use in the theme file, for example, this show module VirtualMart flypatch top, for example. And then you have in your Joomla configuration, you can add any module you have and type VM or VirtualMart product flypatch top, and this module will be loaded there. And you don't have to care for all the other things that, as you know, from modules, it's a complete program. It is loaded there. And as a special trick, what we often do is we add some more flexibility. When you, for example, have the browse pages, the category overview pages, and you want to add modules there, then it's sometimes useful to show different modules on different browse pages. Then you can just use this example, what I said, this show modules category browse page top, for example, and add the category ID at the end of the module position name. And then in your Joomla backend, you can place a module in this position you just defined, and add the category ID, and then this module will only be shown on the one category page. So you make it even more flexible to show categories show modules on different categories. Otherwise, it's a bit difficult. This is one thing I'm often asked: how to place modules on VirtualMart, on specific VirtualMart pages. I don't know if everybody knows this. You can define in the menu system of Joomla. You can define special item IDs for category pages, for product IDs, for checkout, and so on. But the problem is that you have to rebuild the whole category structure then in the menu system if you want to have an item ID for every category, for example. And then when you change something in the category, you have to change it in the menu system too. So it is much easier and faster to use if you add this module code to the theme, for example. Any more questions at the moment? Nothing? is your question how to install it or how to write the program then? Because
I have a module for and I install it over Joomla. But I need this additional function of add for the PS program.
Yeah.
Yes,
the first thing is that you create the PS product user class and write the code.
By hand.
Yes. You mean when you distribute it and install the module, how will the user class become active? That's the same problem with all the larger extensions where you have modules, plugins, components in one package, and you will need an install script that handles this for you then. But this is called automatically by Joomla, of course. When there is an install script in the installation package, it will be called. And the disadvantage there is that you don't know if there is already a PS product file. So you have to check this because there is no real installer for this at the moment. And it's not very, very widely used, this, so we never have had any conflicts yet, but you really should check for the existence of a file. Any other questions for the... Yeah, we cannot connect to the service here. We are not that much people here. If you want to meet, if you have more detailed questions, we can meet down in the lobby where we have better internet access and check special things or answer questions with online access.
No.
Yes, I don't know, you might know that there is the WirtualMod 1.5 in development at the moment. This version will surely work with Joomla 1.6. WirtualMod 1.1 has the problem that it's stated that it will be backward compatible to Joomla 1.0 and even Mambo, but to make WirtualMod 1.1 series compatible with 1.6, we will have to break with this Joomla 1.0 compatibility. And the problem is, if the development team is working on a new version, you won't find a lot of enthusiastic people to change the old version. That's not an advertisement. We offer on vmexpert.com, we offer a patch package that will make WirtualMod 1.6 compatible, and also even add a lot of other features which the core team, which we are also part of, but decided not to add to the old feature. Of course, there are a lot of shops with WirtualMod 1.1 that don't want or cannot update even when WirtualMod 1.5 is available. WirtualMod can be run in 1.6. That's for sure. The problem is, it's funny, but we have written this, or we have made this with the February Joomla SVN version, with the version from February this year, and everything worked fine. And when the beta came out some weeks later, nothing worked anymore. So they've changed in the last 4 weeks so much in Joomla 1.6 that we have to check it all again then. But that's the current status. It's a bit difficult because that's not an official version, because it breaks the backwards compatibility, but it will work then, yes. Any other questions so far? I would like to show you some more code examples. If you want to, we can meet downstairs and at a coffee or so, and we can look at the notebook. how we made some things, and the module thing is a very good tip if you know how to use it, because you can do a lot of things in modules, and it's very fast and simple to create a module. Modules are the easiest extensions for Joomla, so that's very, very simple to create this. And we often use, sometimes use modules that don't create any display, just to load it on a specific category page to do something completely different in the background, what the user doesn't see, just to load some settings, because it's very fast to make it in a module. And when there's a limited budget and you don't want to create thousands of lines of code, you just create a module, have 150 lines of code, and it's cheap and it works. And if it doesn't work, just unpublish the module. That's very, very simple and straightforward. So yeah, just find or have the idea to find out what the best way for the solution is. And the most common is really to do it in the themes files, because you have all the options. You can add code there. You must be aware how the theme files are called, how some of the theme files are called. When you, for example, use the browse themes, which is, you might have seen that, browse underscore one, browse two, browse three, and so on. These files are used for each product on the browse page. So if you put some large code in there where you have several database requests and so on, and you have a 50 products category page, then this code will be executed 50 times. So we have seen shops where that were very, very, very slow, only because of the changes in the browse themes, and that's something you should really test. And you should also have a copy of your shop when you work for a live shop. Have a copy on a test server where you can echo all the things you're doing, because then this might look ugly, but it's the easiest way to see how VirtualMart handles these template files. There are a lot of files that you don't even think about that they are called in other places, but sometimes there is a line of or a hierarchy of template files that are called. Easiest or best example is, for example, this product snapshot again calls the price template, because it displays a price, and so they are called in each other. And when you change something in the price template and think, okay, this is my product details, but it's shown in very different places, and some of the themes are even triggered in the category lists. So when you add something, then for each entry in the category list, this is executed. So echo the things you do, and you will see on your page what happens. This is not nice for live pages, but for testing the code, and you should really test it. It's quite good. And use the debug feature in VirtualMart when you're during extending VirtualMart, because it shows you really a lot of information. And even on the live side, you can restrict the display of the debug information to a specific IP. So when you just find out your current IP address and say the debug information should be only shown to IP address, the IP address you entered, then you only see the debug information even on the live side. Even if there are 50 other customers on the site, they won't see it, but you can see it. And sometimes you have bugs or what you cannot reproduce on a test server. They only come up when other users are active at the same time and so on. So this helps a lot. Yes, any more questions? Yeah, I hope that this was a small view into the options you have when you want to extend VirtualMart, some useful tips, and I really can repeat myself. Just ask me to show you something online. That's a bit disappointing that we don't have internet access in this room here now, because most of the stuff we have is on the test server, and yeah, we can answer very specific. We have done a lot. We can answer a lot of specific questions then in the code then. Yeah. Okay, then it's also nearly 4 o'clock. Then maybe see you better downstairs then. Thank you.